Good morning, everybody. How are you? This is Theron. Welcome to Minecraft LAN Party. Hey, guys. Why don't you come with me? Let's do a little exploring. I think that's a grand idea. So, how are you? So, in last episode, we built our little snow platform up there, which will become the ice farm. It's not there yet. I'm going to spend some time off camera doing that. I think there's a plain biome out behind there, and I want to see what's there. Might be something interesting. Who knows? So, hey dog, I need maybe I'll find a name tag so I can name the dog. Oop. All right, see you later, Wendell. I don't know why I just called him Wendell. I think that's a grand name for a snow golem, but maybe that's what we'll call him. We'll call him Wendell. I need two name tags. Hey, there we go. So, we're just going to explore a little bit. Oh, careful, ravine dog. Ugh. So I need something to talk about, I guess, while we explore a bit. Oh, you know, it wouldn't be a bad idea to remember where we are here. About 6,000 on the Z, or Z if you're from one of those countries where they mispronounce things. Or rather, don't pronounce them the way that we Americans do. Well, I came out this far, at least, because I lit up this cave. But I haven't gone too far. Oh, this tall grass is a little bit annoying. Look, pumpkins. So, it is, for me, it's August 13th, although by the time I post this, it'll probably be a couple weeks out, probably being closer to the end of August, getting close to September. And, September, this year means Minecon. Minecon in Anaheim, California, which is pretty close to where I'm from. So, I'm going to be going to Minecon. I'm actually volunteering. I will be a Minecon agent, a little squiddy. So I'm going to be working. I love the sound of the dog shaking the water off. Look at all the sheep. Should build a sheep farm out here. Hi. So I'll be working. I don't know what I'll be doing. They haven't told anyone yet, but I'll probably be, you know, standing at I don't know, maybe like conference rooms, helping everybody come in and out, helping collect tickets, or I don't know, there's lots of things I could be doing. So that's cool. Looking forward to that. I like working events like this. Maker Faire, something I go to on a regular basis pretty much every year. Bark. How's your tail doing, dude? Oh, you're doing all right. Not that you'd have any reason to be hurt at this point. Tonight, a couple things going on. Space related. Not that I'm Kurt J. Mack or anything, but SpaceX is going to be launching a communication satellite tonight, which means they're probably going to be launching into a geostationary or geosynchronous orbit, which is pretty high up. So it means that the chances of them landing the first stage successfully back on the barge, assuming they use the barge, they might land on land again like they did last time. But the barge landing would be less likely to succeed, but I'm sure they will attempt it. And so that's cool. So I'll be watching that tonight. And but tonight and last night more so, but tonight continues the I think it's the Perseid meteor shower. So I may step outside, although there's an awful lot of light pollution where I live, so it's really difficult to see meteor showers. If I really wanted to see it, I would have to head out into the middle of nowhere. Hello guys. There's the Angeles National Forest just north of where I live, and that's actually a fine place to go and see, because there aren't a lot of lights up there, and the and so you can go find a spot, pull over to the side of the road, and just look up and see the stars really well, and see the meteors. So that's cool. What else? Bark. Not a whole lot else going on next week. The Riff Tracks Live is doing Mothra in theaters. So they're going to be showing Mothra and then riffing the movie while it plays. They'll be doing that live from a theater probably in Minnesota, I think is where they do that typically. So that's probably where they'll do it from. Look at all these sheep. It's crazy. It's crazy, I tell you. So that's, and then they show that, they broadcast that out by satellite out to theaters all over the country, which is really cool. It's kind of a neat way of seeing it, is you get to see the live experience. It's tape delayed in California, unfortunately. Otherwise, I'd have to go super early. Oh, pigs! But that's, you know, that's neither here nor there. But it's pretty cool. So I'll go see that. It's on Thursday, the 18th, I think. Yeah. I'm trying not to. It's a couple days after the first anniversary, 1 year anniversary of my mom's passing. So I'm trying not to focus on that too much, but that's coming up. So I'm sure next week will be a little bit rough. Should I be collecting some of these oxeye daisies? They might be useful for something. I only have 11 pork chops, but I have a whole stack of golden carrots. And now that I have a gold farm, golden carrots are easy. But if I want a little bit of fun, oh, come on. You need more practice than that. So now I have raw pork chops. If you get hungry or hurt, I can help you. Oh, that's just stupid silly. Okay. There you go. And I get a little bit of experience for that, too. The other thing going on right now is Olympics. I didn't record last weekend. I haven't played a lot of Minecraft over the last week or so because of the Olympics. The company I work for is helping NBC, as you might be aware, is broadcasting or streaming some selected events from the Olympics in Rio in 4K HDR. HDR standing for High Dynamic Range. So instead of the standard range of brightnesses that your TV can display, assuming that you don't have a new fancy 4K HDR TV, these things can get super bright, and some of the stuff looks really fantastic. To some extent, you have to wonder, why bother with indoor sporting events? But they actually look pretty nice. So we have been helping with that, and it's been a lot of work. And last weekend was, I didn't get a whole lot of rest. Whoa. Uh-oh. Cool down. Okay. Hey, dog. Haha. Transporter. He don't need no ender pearls. So, oh, we got more snowy terrain up here. Oh man, you know what would be so nice? I would love to find an ice spikes biome, because I don't have any packed ice, and packed ice would be very handy thing to have indeed. Okay, it's starting to get late. Whoops. I have a bed in my ender chest. Make sure that's my silk touch pick first. Yeah, okay. And let us put down the bed and go to sleep, so we don't spawn too many bad guys. Bark. All right. So I think we were headed off this direction, I think. Well, we'll find out. Hey, chicken. Hanging cave there. So we get in these really nice looking 4K HDR files. Hey, there's a swamp over there. Witch hut. Witch hut. Okay, this is pretty far out, but yeah, it's a witch hut though. Meaning, I can build a witch farm. Which is great because then I can have a nice supply of glowstone without having to go farming it in the Nether. Bark, yes, indeed. There's only one of them in sight of this, but that's pretty cool. So we'll have to do that. Now, they broke something about the way witch farms worked. Bark. In one of the 1.9 releases, or one of the 1.8 releases, like 1.86 or something, they changed the way like shifting floors, entities interact with shifting floors. Never quite figured out what exactly it was. So the witch farm that I built last season on Minecraft LAN Party will not work. But we will, there are updated designs that will work, so we'll just go with that. That's pretty cool. Do I need a flower pot? I don't think so. Oh, birch forest. Let's go around this way. So that's cool. Found a witch hut at least. So Olympics are going on. We got and I don't know how well it's doing for NBC to be showing the 4K games, you know, the 4K coverage. But it is a pretty impressive way of watching the Olympics. Hello, mister. Oh, don't. I hope he's not gonna set the dog on fire, is he? Hope not. That would really suck. If burning zombies could catch your dog on fire. I need to eat. Let's do that. There we go. How you doing? Oh, you're doing fine. Okay, cool. So I don't know. But I've been watching. I've got a in the lab where I work. I've got like a 65 inch brand spanking new Samsung 4K HDR TV. It's super nice. Looks great, even playing HD stuff. But I've got a few 4K Blu-ray discs, which is super spiffy. So I've been watching those. I need to get some more because they're a lot of fun. And the Olympics, so I've been going through and watching that coverage. There's a few providers that are showing the 4K stuff. Do I go down here? Sure, why not? It's probably not much down here. I know, like DirecTV showing on one of their channels, and if you've got the proper package, and their proper packages are expensive. Comcast is showing it streaming on demand. Nothing down here. Except iron. Always take the iron. And what? Hey, the coal can't hurt. A little more iron. Hey, I hear a zombie. There must be a cave off here. So I've been that's been taking up a lot of my time lately. Which is cool. Still noon outside. Okay, let's head back up. I think I passed some iron on the way down. Hey, there we go. There's some more iron. Always use the iron. More iron. Yeah, there we go. Wow, birch forest. I don't know that I need. I don't need birch trees. I've got birch trees. I've got birch trees, wood and sapling and everything. So, don't really need to explore the birch tree forest. Oh boy. And yeah. So Olympics. Oh, look at the horsies. Oh, I wonder if the horses are worthwhile on the server here or not. I don't know. Let's find out. Hey. You got spots. I like you. Oh, you know what? Oh, give me your love. Give me your love. Oh, you are through me. Give me your love. Oh, you will. You will love me. Give me your love. Give me the hearts. Oh, almost. You're almost. Oh, hello. Oh, okay. Let me get off. How do I get off? There we go. I have in my ender chest. I have a saddle. You were the one that loved me, right? Yeah. Oh, saddle goes here. Yeah, hello. You got a few hearts. I don't know how good of a jumper you are, but hey. You should be able to put saddles on horses, on cows. Ah, that's pretty cool. The other Minecraft news is that they started releasing snapshots for 1.12. Now, it seems awfully soon because 1.11 just came out and they didn't add that much to 1.11, which was kind of weird. But they put this up here. But 1.12, they released the first snapshot for it this week. So that's kind of interesting. They didn't really change anything, and they didn't fix the bug where you can shoot mobs standing behind you or sitting behind you in a boat. But most of what they did were mob fixes. The one thing that they did fix, which was nice, and actually I should try out to see if it affects the horses at all. When you're in a boat now in 1.12, it shows you your hunger bar, because it was possible before to actually starve to death while you were in a boat and not realize that that's what was happening, which is no good. Is this a flower forest? I believe it is. Plains. No. We just got tulips. Okay, I want some tulips. I'm going to take off the saddle and get off the horse, and we're going to collect some tulips, because I don't really have tulips at all. Yeah. And the other thing that they adjusted, and it seemed like a weird choice at first, but I guess it kind of then made sense when they sort of explained it, that because saturation is such an important game mechanic now, especially when it comes to combat, They basically made it so that most other activities that would normally cause you to lose saturation, like walking or riding in a boat, will now consume much less saturation. So it looks like what that means is that as you're walking around or running around, you don't get hungry as much. Which is interesting. It's kind of, I mean, it's convenient because it's always been kind of annoying how much food you have to go through. Like my tunnel through the Nether to get down to the portal for the Taiga, my modified Taiga Island. I generally, by the time I run down that, I have to eat twice if I'm eating the pork chops, which is a little bit annoying. So now that should be reduced. So that's cool. To me, I don't know if making the game generally easier is a good thing, but I like the challenging aspects of Minecraft, although I don't like it when it gets too crazy hard. But here we go. Tulips, I got white and orange and pink. There are red tulips, right? I think. Ba-dop. I think there are, but I'm not seeing any. Not that it matters from a dye standpoint, because there's so many sources of red dye in this game. Especially with beetroots now a thing. Plop, plop, plop. Put the saddle back on the horse. And where else are we gonna go? There's a cave over there. Oh, there's red tulips down here. Yes, there are red tulips. Okay, let's collect some of these. And fill out my flower collection. So, 1.12 snapshots. I didn't do a 1.11 snapshot tour because it seemed like they were going to release super quickly. One of the nice things about 1.9 was it took them quite a while. It was kind of like the way 1.8, they spent their time, they took their time. Where did my horse go? They took their time getting it right. Some people complained about how long it took them, how long they were working on it. Where did the horse go? I didn't get the saddle off. Oh, here you are. You're enjoying the tulips, weren't you? Whoa, don't fall down there. But they announced that there weren't really going to be a lot of new features. What's going on here? Obviously, I can't go up that way. Back from the edge. They weren't going to add a lot of new features to the game until Minecon, when they were going to announce the features that they were going to. Oh, this is really dumb. It's one downside of horses. Makes it harder to get around in some ways. So I don't expect, although I expect them to continue to release snapshots, it seems like they're going to be largely bug fix snapshots. And until September, when they announce new features at Minecon. So we'll see. I might be up for doing another snapshot tour series. And then I would probably start doing that after Minecon, especially if they announce some cool features. high dog. But I don't expect, I don't anticipate I'll be doing anything along those lines before then. Oh. So the most annoying thing about horses, they can't swim. They need to be able to swim because horses are able to swim, at least to some extent. Get my saddle. I think this might be the way where we part ways. Let me get coordinates so I can come back and find you. But I want to go over there. And I think it's going to be more frustrating and annoying to do it on a horse than to do it on foot. So, so anyway, I don't know. So yeah, I don't know if I'm going to be doing a snapshot tour series for 1.12, because it could be that they announce at MineCon, oh look, these all these awesome new features, and it's available today. So snapshots, you know, a series of snapshots the way they did 1.8 and 1.9 may be a thing of the past for Mojang. Maybe, don't know. So, okay, and I don't know that we're gonna find anything else too terribly interesting out this way, so we'll probably call that an episode. I'll continue exploring a bit, but I'll kind of make my way back to my modified taiga island, get to work on the ice farm, and maybe come out and do some more exploring at some point. Oh wait, lilacs. Two tall flowers. I don't know that I have any of these. And these are useful for dyes because you could bone meal them and get the dyes. So I definitely want to collect these. Yeah. All right. Whoa, big old forest. More birch trees. Birch trees as far as you can see. Okay. Yeah, I don't think there's anything else too terribly interesting going to happen. So I will leave it here. And we will see you in the next episode. Or hopefully we'll be working on, I'll have some ice farm action. And maybe we'll go exploring elsewhere, because I still need to find, I know there's an ocean monument near the spawn island. I'll take more of these. I know that that's the case, but I don't know that I've seen it. I saw it on the Amist map when I was looking for seeds to play with, so I know it's there. But I don't have a good idea where it is. So we will have to go find that, because sea lanterns would be really nice. So I need to build a guardian farm, which is a whole ton of work, but do want to do it. So anyway, actually I think I'm kind of slowly heading back towards the Taiga Island at this point anyway. So we'll call that an episode. I hope it was at least somewhat interesting. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. All right, bye.